Hey guys, welcome to Ham Radio with K0PIR, my YouTube channel. Happy New Year. I hope you had a safe and fun New Year's Eve. I didn't do very much. I was at home with my brother and sister, and we watched football games. So, not a big deal. But anyway, it's January 1st, 2023. And my first video, I'm going to finish up this series on Wfview Log for the Old Man, WSJT-X, and GridTracker. So let's take a look at Wfview first. I have a post on my website, and it has these screen captures, but I want to show you port 4532, and I've got the rig control enabled. I'm going to go over to view, and you can see it's working. I'm on 10 meters right now, and there's been activity all day on 10 meters. Got WSJT-X pulled up. Let's go over and look at the settings here. First is the radio tab, and up here at rig, we've got Hamlib net rig control, and that was from Wfview. Then we've got the network server, the local address, and 4532. That port's the one we just looked at in Wfview. All of this is grayed out, so you don't need any of it. Push to talk is cat. Transmit audio is the rear. Mode is data. And split operation is fake it. I use fake it or rig, and I recommend you use either one of those. It keeps your transmission in the sweet spot, so you get the most power out and the cleanest signal. There's more information on that on the WSJT-X website, the Princeton website. You can find out more information about that. So if you see your transmitter jump off frequency when you transmit, not a problem. That's the way it's supposed to work. Okay, and then let's go over to the audio tab and the USB audio codec, input and output. Then on the reporting tab, we want to look at the UDP server. That's a local address, and then port 2237, and you want to have all these enabled. That does it for WSJT-X. So let's take a look at, let me go back to Log for the Old Man. For this, there's really no special settings in Log for the Old Man. I didn't have to put any paths in there for UDP or logging, nothing like that. GridTracker is going to do the logging. I'll minimize that, and let's bring up GridTracker. We'll go over to the settings, and the first tab is a general tab, and there's that port 2237, so it's receiving UDP data from WSJT-X, and you can see it's receiving over here. Still plenty of activity on 10 meters. And then let's go over to the logging tab. And in logging, I have got Log for the Old Man down here. Got that checked off in that local port. Then the default's 2236. And that's all you need. So when I log a contact, a FT8 contact, I'll see it pop up over here and give me an alarm. So I know that it's logged. So that does it. I'm not going to push it because my laptop's bogged down right now. It's being really slow. I have to clean it up and get some software removed from it. So thanks for watching. Please remember to like, subscribe, and share. Also tell your friends. And if you haven't already, look down below. You'll see a t-shirt, sweatshirt, maybe a coffee mug. That's my Ham Radio t-shirt shop. And these designs are by me and some other people that I know. So if you find a design you like, that's a good way to support this channel. And again, thanks for watching 73 and good DX.